In 2015, we made a choice to protect Canada's lakes, rivers, and oceans. Stephen Harper had protected less than 1% of our marine and coastal areas, and in the 6 years since, we've boosted that to 14% and on our way to 30%. We've worked with provinces, territories, and Indigenous partners to safeguard freshwater, and we're banning harmful single-use plastics and ending plastic waste by 2030. We've done a lot, and now we're choosing to do even more.
There are a lot of ways that we can really tackle emission reductions to meet a net zero by 2050 goal and actually export those solutions, those technologies to other countries, thereby generating more jobs in the process. That's a key part of Canada's recovery plan and a key part of getting people back to work. The thing I liked the most about the proposal for Northern Gateway was the economic partnerships for Indigenous communities. Indigenous communities were going to have 33% ownership. I would like to see intergenerational transfer of wealth and opportunity after generations of trauma transfer. Mr. Trudeau canceled that pipeline without consulting the Indigenous owners. He failed in his duty to consult. That's not the way we have economic reconciliation. And we have to recognize that Canadian energy is environmentally and socially leaders in comparison with other energy producers. So over time, as we see a lower carbon future, we should make sure that democratic countries use Canadian resources, not resources from Saudi Arabia or Venezuela or Russia. That will be our approach in getting access to tidewater and supporting economic reconciliation as part of that.